It happens a bit too often that you die with a lot of scrap, which is something we've talked about earlier. I guess he was waiting for store to buy like cloaking and some other system. Necrorebel's Labeyran was too tough for me to watch after Sector 3. How come? I don't want to try and go for a crew kill here. I will use the Iron Blast. Not because I need to take down the shields for the heavy pierce, but so the Solar Flare will cause more damage on their ship. Sold heal for a clone bait, which is fine. Yeah, I can see why you do that when you play no pause. And even if you play with pause, I think it's fine to buy clone bay. I wouldn't like to pick up a med bay that early, not if you have to sell the bomb as well. But clone bay is so much better, thanks to all the blue options. So I can see that. Then in Sector 2 he buffered teleporter for blue option friendly slaver event, and then upgraded clone bay. And then in Sector 3 upgraded clone bay again. He had no additional crew weapons. That seems weird. In general, I'm not fond of upgrading the ship just for some blue options. Unless it's like Sensor 2, which have a lot of blue options. Or for some of the very powerful blue options like Kazak in Mantis Homeworlds. Just feel that you don't gain that much from it. Especially not that early. Even if you get like a higher reward, it's probably not worth the 30 or so scrap investment. I was doing the math on Kazak, and even if you have to upgrade both sensors and the med bay in Sector 4 or possibly even Sector 5, you don't gain enough scrap from the extra rewards from the blue options, despite it being very good. Scott had cloaking and hacking at the time. Sounds like a pure misplay and sloppiness to not upgrade shields or engines even more then. I think there's an Ion Blue option in Sector 1 Distress. I should know this, since I compiled a list of all the blue options. Yeah. There's the malfunctioning defense system. Where I get high scrap reward. And I have rocks as well, so I should visit this distress beacon. High scrap and an augment. Not a very good augment, but might be somewhat useful. At least it isn't something bad. So I'll try to take out their weapons with heavy pierce first. And then, as the flare hits, I will use the iron blast. Not sure if it matters that much how we use the iron blast here. Should probably have flashed my shields there. Although, kind of don't want to even try for those more advanced strats. Too much micromanagement. I'd rather play it safe, since my micro play isn't that good. 35 scrap for maybe free crew. I know I do the pilot upgrade, though I know. Though I now try not to do it when scrap is low, learn from the NDA run. Stores more likely to be found. Maybe iron pelting, but after weapons are down, you're probably fine. Yeah. That's pretty much the thing in all the pulsars. As long as you take their weapons down early, you're probably fine. If they had more hull, I might have gone for the crew kill here. I'll take this surrender offer. 5 fuel is quite useful, and a decent amount of events where you sell missiles or trade them. I watched the first two episodes of a new show today with Ricky Gervais in the lead role. It's a comedy about depression, you could say. The main character lost his wife to cancer, and we follow him a while after while he's super depressed and thinking about taking his life, and he kind of learns to see the positive things in life. At least it seems to take this direction. So, it has had some really good scenes so far. So, if it sounds interesting, I'd say that it's worth to look on an episode or two, see if it's something for you. I guess I should buy the backup battery here. Don't want to go the teleporter route. Don't know if there's any reason to sell anything here. This sector one has been amazing. Yeah, I guess. I've got an 86 scrap, 105 scrap, 152, 167 scrap, and a human, and I have one jump left. So it's well above average. And I guess you could say the Ion Blast is worth more than 15 scrap, since I actually have use for it. Three free items, one crew. Yeah. I don't need scrap for anything right now. You know what I mean? FTL Jammer isn't great, nor is Rock Plating, but I don't have to sell them now. It's quite unlikely that I will find two free augments before the next store. And if the run turns to shit, I might want to use the Burst Laser free later on. And I definitely want to keep all these free weapons. I think it's fine to buy. Oh yeah, forgot about the backup battery, as usual. Wait, I guess it's roughly 200 scrap and the human that I received since I bought the backup battery. So yeah, that's well above average. I'd rather keep the fuel here. I'm quite likely to have a decent amount of drone pouch anyway for when I buy hacking later. try this way directly. See if I get a breach. If I only had 4 weapons power here, it would be so much easier. Kind of don't want to bother. Gendry is so annoying. You have to think to get the crew kill there. I don't want it. Just want a relaxing run. I should probably go to that store. See if I can find like a burst laser one or something. So that's something. What more should I do here? I want to buy the long range scanners. See if I can get a high scrap run. Found the fight. Good. Yeah, I want that long range scanners. If I only had 3 scrap more. But I guess I can sell the rock plating. The correct thing is probably to sell something more and get hacking, but that's not as fun. So this is a dead beacon, so I will go this way instead. They're running away. If only I had a FTL jammer. That's rude. I shouldn't take any damage here. Not with the triple fire. Stop taking my weapons offline, please. I'll take the Crowkill here instead, even though it's a good reward. I have so many missiles now. Say, Crow, I'm good at the game. What skill? Yeah, I know. I've told Farb about this strat, just finding three flak ones early on. It really pays off. You're barely guaranteed to win now. Upgraded main control. A road. So is that five things I've received for free now? I think so. And it's only late sector 2. I guess I should use this setup for now. And then I'll probably switch the Ion Blast for Heavy Pierce. Yeah, the ship cheated. Yeah, the game does that sometimes. And as usual, they board into Oxygen. I'd really like to see the game files for this ship and like the Sultan A, where they like to board into sensors. It feels like there is something, at least on some ships, where they have a priority for a certain room to board into. It happens so often that they go into Oxygen on this ship. I can't believe that it's completely random. Don't really need a crew member. I already have a human, and Mantis don't have many good blue options, and I don't need fighting crew either. So ship had one shield, little missile and beam drone activated. That's 5 power. It had drone control, 2 weapons, 1 piloting, 1 and engines, 2 shields were 2 or 3. But even if free, that's 8 reactor. Unless they gain best reactor for piloting. Can't imagine that they do. I guess Twinch is the right person to ask if you have any questions about it. I don't know the rules enough, so I can't really comment on it. I guess Sultan is fine. I have quite good weapons for it. I just want to find fights. So I would like to go here. Just to get this extra jump. Let's check the FTL sector guide. See what it says about Sultan sector. Notable items: teleporter, medbay 3, sensors 2 and 3. Salt unhealthy, yeah. Okay. Didn't notice any health shenanigans, but wouldn't surprise me. So I will kill this one. Nice. So I would like to find a store. Still have plenty of things to sell, so I can afford to upgrade my ship. This is somewhat greedy to take this fight. Okay, so I hope I'm safe now for a while. So that's about as bad as it can get. For Mantis, no doors, no possibility to vent, and very slow crew on my ship. Normally you shouldn't take any damage there. I should be guaranteed the crew kill now. No store still. If I only had more hull, this could have been such a great sector. So many fights nearby. Wait. Map event? Yeah, figured that. Was it the 50-50 between fight and map upgrade? Should really read a bit more carefully here. Double repair drone, so not worth to try and go for a crew kill here. could have been Salt and Ship Tour, which is map 100%. Okay. So I can't go store, fight, store. That's probably the best option. It's probably correct to buy cloaking here. Doesn't leave me many options for the next store, but well, I guess I can go 1-2 exit as well. That seems better. Even though it's a decent chance this is a empty beacon. I think I'd have both engines again, have so much money, and dodging an Artemis might be nice. Yeah. Probably safer, really. I can't say that I'm playing optimally here, not close to it. We'll probably never use this defense drone, but still, nice reward. No reason to go to this nebula beacon. It won't give me an extra jump. If I didn't use this mod so I can see where the fleet will jump, I would have gone here. Possibly. If I didn't have longer range scanners, I would. So it's an interesting thing to note. That's one of the rare instances where I really gain some information by using this mod. Death drone isn't too bad in Rock Bay, I don't think. No, just that mind control and hacking are the systems I want to buy. Especially now when I have cloaking already. So I shot down the missile there, which is unfortunate. Again, a repair drone. Otherwise, I would have switched to the firebomb here. Right, and they already have cloak. Yeah. I didn't even realize repair drone takes less damage from weapons. It's not something I've thought about a lot either. Just think that they are so annoying to encounter. So it's not optimal to use the backup battery that early, but it's safer. So I'm sure that I can power the cloak with max engines. Crew kill? I think not. Repair bot probably. Yeah. Repair drones are probably the biggest jerks in the universe. Preventing all the fun. Again, where's my FDL jammer? Can't believe I'm saying this, but I actually missed the augment. probably upgrade piloting after this. Goblin memes a lot and his Mikri isn't at the same level of others. I can see that being true about him. He really seems to be more about having fun than play optimally. Which is totally fine. Just not the typical way for FTL streamers, I guess. Or well, not the FTL streamers that I watch. Like he plays around his weaknesses versus improving, I feel. He once sold the Burstless run to get the flak when I thought he had better options, and argued that it times out better for him. Yeah. So basically he plays like I do now. Like, I know what you should do to play a lot better, but I just can't handle the micro part of it. I mean, it's very good to be able to recognize your weakness and know how to play around them, but you need to improve as well and just do runs to get better. Hey, they're boarding into my oxygen again. What a surprise. There are a few places I can improve, but I typically don't have to worry about micro. Yeah, pause makes it so easy. What are the areas where you think you can improve? So I'll go 1, 2 here, and then down here. Just so I can get both Nebula beacons. This like bad blue options. Not sure if I care about that mind control at all. Just need to deal some more damage to their weapons and I will be safe. I said deal more damage to their weapons. I'd say that's somewhat unfortunate. Don't think I played it incorrectly. If I only hadn't sold the Iron Blast earlier, I could have done a fun meme setup with multiple ions. So, is this manually searched the wreckage? Yay! Piloting upgrade paying off. And I'm back up to 300 scrap again. Feels good, man. Probably take a fair amount of damage here. Thought I was going to take more damage there. Was somewhat lucky with the later volleys from them. I'm taking out their piloting to ensure that my next volleys hit helped a lot as well. Third time I see this cloaking blue option. Shouldn't be taking any more damage now. I let chat distract me. I forget about using Sultans to negate ions. I should learn Masala's boarding micro. I really forgot you can board with crystals on autoships. Like they last a long time, allowing for risks. Unlike sensors though, level 2 piloting has the benefit of FTL charges. And you can still dodge stuff when it takes 1 damage. Yeah, letting chat distract you is so easy. I mean, you are a fairly experienced streamer now. But I have a lot of problems with chat still. Don't know how many hours I've streamed, but well above 100. But I think that's the biggest thing for a lot of people. At least for newer streamers. It's so hard to be good at talking to chat and still good at playing the game. I guess you kind of have to get good enough so you can play the game on autopilot, more or less. I don't have a very talkative chat until the past month or so. Yeah. Oh. This could have gone bad. Not sure if I should keep the firebomb. I guess keep it for phase one against the flagship is good enough. Don't want to use the chain burst laser. Well, this happens. Could go like this as well. And have the Iron Charger take down one shield. And then fire the flak. Might actually be better than the chain laser. Well, charge two is two shots per 10 seconds. Yeah, that's true. It just is an additional weapons upgrade. And I don't want to have it for the end game. Although, I mean, I can afford it. I received so many free stuff this run. Hey, I still have the firebomb. Maybe take out the firebombs to have more critical opportunities. I could, but I don't think it's worth the trouble for me here. The setup is good enough to finish the game with. I don't need more scrap really. I'm far ahead of the curve. And I think the risk is that I will just end up taking more damage if I try to prolong the fights. What does this Sector 6 Mantis ship without a teleporter? Is it double iron bomb? Manually search the wreckage? No. They don't use MC because of Nebula or what? Yeah, they have to depower some of their systems. Yeah, it was an iron storm. The biggest mistake in the run was selling the FTL Gemma. Yeah, pretty much. I really missed it. Actually, somewhat scary weapon setup. So I have to wait for the cloaking now. So this ship can have they have 14 missiles. That's quite a lot. If they would have a breach missile, you could only dodge 13 of them in a row with your cloak. And then you have to be lucky the last time. If I remember correctly from my copy's video. I could go the far route and use firebomb and stun bomb against the flagship. I could have gained 300 scrap less this run, but it wouldn't have affected me at all. I like that we meme with words and not gameplay. Yeah. Puns, they are the high point of comedy. Let's see what the sector guide says about these two. Kind of just want to go to the slugs for the extra one half of a store. Or I could, well, if I had both teleporter and clone bay, I could have so many blue options in the pirate sector. Let's just go pirate. I dislike slugs. It was probably better to go to the slug sector, but well, who cares? Stop dodge my missiles, please. Actually did the micro correct there, still punished. Hey, got a crew kill. Whoops. Was a bit too slow there. Hopefully no one saw that mistake. I, for one, didn't see. Was getting coffee. Well, that's good. You didn't miss anything. I'll probably eat this missile, but feel it's better in the long run to take out their evasion first. And I totally forgot about the end as well. I have too many crew members to take care of. It's hard to keep track of 7. can afford to spend some scrap. On the other hand, I could try and get 1,000 unspent scrap. Whoops. Well, so much for that better double reward. Hey, it's a good system. And the correct thing here is to by hacking this shitty augment, sorry, shitty drone, that's no fun at all to play with. Part of me wants to skip hacking here. I would skip hacking if mind control was available. Just for fun. But I guess I should buy it. Despite it being a stupid system. So if I go to that store, I will lose a jump. Only 42 drone parts. Yeah, exactly. Well, so much for that better double won the war, and now I am behind your door. I tried so hard to pay the law. Well, screw that store. I want more scrap. Can't get enough. Alright, I'm heading out. Good luck with your run. Thanks. It was nice to have you stop by a while and chat. Take care, and I'll see you later. Surrender is not an option. Not now, not ever. Unless I get a superb reward. Main run is like 15% me winning thanks to Sector Guide. Yeah, exactly. For that 2 times I used it. Although, I guess you can technically say that I had use of it in 4 sectors, thanks to the triple civilian sector. Hey, in charge too. Yeah. That prevented me from getting crew kills on all these fights. Not sure if that's really a argument in favor for you. I don't need engines. Can't be carrying you all run. Bye. You're gonna use charge hang, not fireball. Well, that might be true. Oh, you can't put that fire out. Let me help you a bit by draining the oxygen from the weapons room. Slugger Pearl Gill didn't help them that much. Only 49 scrap though. I want more. I have too many systems to micro now. Almost 1,000 scrap. Hacking makes it so much easier to win this fight. Just decrease their evasion to zero. I'll allow myself one power bar here to make the micro slightly easier. Thank you. You should man the doors here. It's a very important place. mean, I can still take damage here, mainly from the drone, or sorry, the beam weapon. So I killed one there. Don't mind using a lot of missiles here. So rude. You're not supposed to deal me damage. No. That was the wrong button. I was not supposed to cloak there. I wanted to use hacking instead. I've only gotten one crew killed so far, which is quite bad. Well, not that great of a phase one. Quite disappointed that I didn't manage to get more crew kills, actually. Oh well. So I am allowed to spend 34 scrap here. Because I'm still over 1,000. Wrong hack to get crew kills. Yeah. Maybe I should have hacked missiles instead. The charge too is so awkward to use. So I got one or two kills there, I think. I think I got two kills. I'm not sure, but it looked like it. This third phase might still be problematic with mind control and boarding. Thank you. Well, he is suing in the end. Only took 10 damage and no pause. With 1,000 scrap unspent. And a very high score as well. Not surprising. I got so many good rewards during this run. I don't think my scrap total should be that high, maybe 2,200. Wow. And I got so many free weapons and drones. Really didn't think it would be 2560 scrap. But yeah, I'm very happy with that run. I got super carried. But regardless, it was fun. But yeah, that's all for me for now. One run is quite enough, especially on Opus. But yeah, thanks for stopping by and take care.